In mystery meat news.
Oh no, unicorn.
Ooh.
What?
Oh.
Submitted by I Didn't Mean It.
You got blocked by somebody here, huh?
Yeah.
That's what happens.
Probably. Oh, is that what the, oh wow. A South Korean man killed his neighbor's dog and invited him over to eat it.
What in the fuck?
That's like the ultimate revenge move.
That sounds like some American shit, though.
Can I say this, though? Korean people are very, very revengey. Like, we pride ourselves in that type of shit.
Vengeful.
You can see a lot of, like, vengeful films, like Korean films, and they always satisfy a certain part of my soul.
Revenge comes from ego, generally.
I know why. Mm. Because Korea always got invaded.
Yeah, we were just like...
My ancestors are responsible for that.
Chinese people, too. We were just fucking everybody's bitch. If you hear, like... You literally listen to, like, art history, like, our music is sad as fuck. Our folk, you know, like, how there's, like, old, like, white people music, right? And it's like, I was walking down a river and I grabbed a, you know, our shit's like, we were, like, raped, we're, like, crying, death. That's all of our old folk song.
Oh, yeah, you know, old black people folk music is, like, just real helpless.
Yeah, that's, like, our shit, too.
It really is. I mean,
blues, it's blues.
Yeah.
I'm helpless shit, man.
I love blues, though. It's
What's
like
that one
sad.
Song but... is Masagona Sellers Tomorrow.
Well, like, you mean those hymns, though?
Yeah.
What would they call them?
Negro spirituals.
Spirituals.
Oh, Negro spirituals. That's right. That's right. Dave is my boy.
Dave, I love too much.
I learned that in elementary school, and we would have to sing, like, we would over...
You had to sing old Negro songs.
Yeah. And things like that, because we were learning about it for Black History Month.
Mm.
And I would...
At the end of it... Well, my teacher was black, too.
You know, oh, she just did that to be funny. I would love to see a bunch of white kids just lined up singing We Will Overcome.
Hey, kids. Wade in the water.
Wade in the water. Too. All right, I'm
back. That's going to be so fucking funny.
Yeah, I want to see that shit.
Dang. Well, back to this story here,
though. Sorry, we went somewhere.
No, you know, I found out through this article that up to 1 million dogs are consumed in South Korea every year.
That makes sense.
I didn't know that.
Don't be hating on us, though. That's because we were fucking devastated and we were starving. And that was the only thing we could eat. So it just became a part of our culture after.
Well, that number's going down now that more and more people...
Yeah, like, even, like, if you go to Korea, right, not too many people I know eat dog. It's like...
I never went to a dog restaurant when I was
there. It's like in the countryside, and a very specific type of person will eat that shit. Like, it's not like all Korean people are like, oh, you eat dog? Oh, yeah.
Let's go like, Korean dog barbecue.
Yeah, it's like, if you like it, it's kind of like, okay.
My dad says dog's delicious.
I heard from many people.
Would you ever try it?
Honestly, probably yeah. Like, if it has to be the right situation. So, like, if it's in America, it's not even legal, I wouldn't. But if, like, if we went to, like, let's say we went to China or Korea or whatever, and they're like, this is a traditional dish that was meant for dog meat, and culturally this is what everyone does here, and it's okay, then I'd be like, okay, I'll try it. But if it's just for, like, hey, you see that dog? It's cute, huh? I'm gonna kill that motherfucker and you eat it. And I'm like, nah, that's not how I'm gonna do it.
Yeah, because when I dig into it with my chopsticks, I'm thinking of a Pomeranian, like, all fluffy and fucking cute. I'm all like, what part of the fucking, is this his back or
yeah,
what?
Yeah, no, I consider myself, like, a kind of an adventurous eater. Like, I'm down to try anything at least once. But when it came down to the horse meat thing, and, like, I've ridden horses, and I just kept picturing
I don't give a fuck about a horse, to be honest with you.
And I'm just like...
Because I haven't got emotionally close to a horse, you know what I mean? And because it's so widely eaten, like, that's just our shit. Everybody else, they'll eat a fucking horse like it's nothing.
Yeah,
you know
what I mean? Yeah.
Like, it's like Icelandic shit, Mongolian people, like, it's... But eating dogs, like, universally, no, it's not really that common, and people are kind of weird about it.
Because dogs are the closest to, like, humans in just relationship-wise.
Like, we've developed a relationship
like,
with
livestock, animals. Yeah, but then, like, dogs are, like... You're not a cow, you're like an in-house animal, you know?
It's like, it's all perspective. Like, what if in Germany it was really common to have like a pet duck? And in Germany they say like, duck is man's best friend, but then we just out here eating ducks. Like, you know, then they,
well,
it's just all
like
perspective.
That with cows
in India.
And stuff like that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. But I think the big part of this is that homeboy killed his neighbor's dog and then said, yo, dog, you hungry? Come over.
Hey, dog. That's why I think that's the ultimate revenge move, because it's almost like saying, yo, I killed your daughter. Come over and eat this meat. This is bomb. Well, guess what? You just ate your fucking kid, bitch.
Jesus.
That's how I feel like.
Yeah, it's hard for me because every time I see it, I see my dog. You know what I mean? It's just your cute little fucking seal face. So I could just kiss the shit out of it.
So this story doesn't seem like he was like malicious toward the neighbor. It's just the fact that he was just so irritated by the dog's constant barking that there was one day where he just threw a stone at the 2-year-old corgi. And
poor corgi
caused him to pass out. And so apparently the 62-year-old man, after the dog passed out, that's when he claims that he strangled the animal and then cooked it. And then he invited all of his neighbors, including the pet owner, to come and enjoy some dog meat. And then
didn't the neighbor go, where's my dog?
Yeah, so the neighbor was looking for their dog. They even passed out flyers, and the daughter was passing out flyers. Like, everyone, they were even offering a reward of like about $660.
Damn, that's a lot of money, dude.
Yeah. That dog meant a lot
to
them.
They were going all over the town with the dog's picture and phone number and just asking anyone. Like, they even went to his house, and he was just like, no, I mean, I don't know where the dog could go. But at that time when they went to his house, like, that dog was hiding in his barn.
Dead already.
They don't know if he was dead or alive at that point, but that the dog was hiding.
You know what's fucking funny to me? When people put up a missing cat photo and it looks like every basic fucking cat I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah.
Like eating a dead fish, and they're like, if you see this cat, I saw your cat 40 times today, dude. I can't help, it's gone.
Dude, that's why our cats are indoor cats. We never let them out because our cats.
You lose your cats, you're fucked.
Yeah. Right. That's true. Your cats look like each other.
Every fucking cat ever. Yeah.
I've seen a lot of cats.
Dogs have like a very specific type of look, so if you see it, you'll notice the damn dog. But cats are just straight up, and you just look like every fucking cat.
Yeah, there's like 40 breeds of dogs, but there's like 3 cats.
Striped That's or true. Not striped?
Yeah. Was it orange
or not orange? Yeah.
I think my favorite part about it though is that like he didn't even mean to kill the dog. So like I imagine he just like threw the rock and he was like, well, I'm not gonna waste that. Took it in.
I haven't had dog in like 3 years.
Yeah, but apparently the neighbor or the dog owner declined the neighbor's invitation for some dog meat.
Obviously.
He's not a dog meat eater.
Well, and he just lost his dog, so he's like, why am I gonna eat?
What area in Korea is this?
Doggy town.
Southern city of Pyeongtaek.
I don't know where the fuck that place is, but that's definitely like in a more rural area.
My dad was telling me dog has a really distinct smell.
Yes.
So like one day I came home and he's like, just to let you know, our neighbors next door, they're cooking dog. He goes, cause I can smell in there and it smells delicious.
But what does it smell like?
I couldn't tell because I never ate dogs. I don't know what I don't know what to look for, but he could smell it and he's just like, that's dog. They're like stewing some dog over there. Like,
damn.
Cooked dog did not smell nice because when I was in Korea, I remember that smell. It did not smell good. And so like
some people smell like stinky tofu and say that smells smells delicious.
How come people eat dogs and not like cats? Like, what's the difference?
I think there's just more meat on them.
There's fat cats,
People did eat cats when they're starving. Koreans grew a taste for dog during the war when they were like, basically didn't have food and anything. Yeah. So they're like, sorry, gotta eat your dog.
And my dad's telling me dog meat is just more healthy. Like, there's something about it where like, when you eat it, like it really warms you up. So in really cold countries, a lot of people, they ate dogs before.
I don't know if I would take your dad's advice. He probably read it in the Chinese newspaper.
No, it was from experience. He ate dogs. It's like eating ginger, like it warms
beer
you.
While he was eating beer. Sure.
Next to a campfire.
Whatever your parents say, we've learned in this room that we can just take it for face value.
Okay, fine.
I don't know, man. Dog is such a difficult. Like I would probably eat like an iguana or like in a heartbeat before a dog. It's weird.
Or like a guinea pig.
Like I would never eat my dog.
Is there an animal that you like absolutely wouldn't try though?
Dog, maybe.
Like I couldn't do like snake or something.
I could eat a lot of things, but like I think it's the emotional part that fucks with me with the dog stuff.
Yeah, for sure.
That's why I couldn't do the horse.
I've had pet frogs, pet fucking fish, turtle.
Like
I'll eat all that shit. Turtle, I didn't eat though.
Turtle smells like shit.
I think the cuter the animal it is, the less chance I can eat it. Cause like turtles are so freaking cute. They're so cute, I couldn't do it. Like if you gave me a piece of turtle meat, I would just imagine its little head poking out like, don't eat me, Bose. And I'd just start crying and shit.
Turtle looks like fucking live diarrhea to me.
cooked turtle?
Yo, it's like a little dinosaur.
There's this turtle at Mariel's fucking apartment, dude, that just lives in the fucking pond. That fool fucking comes up to me all the time, dude.
You guys look the same.
Yeah, that's probably true too. And we're like at the same speed and pace. But that motherfucker's so cute. Every time I sit out that bench, this fool just pops up.
How cute.
I'm like, yo, what's up?
Did you name him?
Archibald. So his name's Archie. Sup, Archie? I fucking love that motherfucker, dude.
Oh my god, now that Gio said it, I can't unsee the turtle. I can't unsee it. And then right after that, you made a little turtle face. Oh my god.
Even more.
That's good that she thinks you're cute.
I thank you. They say that my spirit animal is a sea turtle.
Who's they?
Oh, yeah.
Just Twitter. And like all these people, they say like I'm a sea turtle. I
could probably eat human before I eat a dog.
Joe's been thinking about that for like the past 5 minutes.
Silent, bro.
I couldn't eat dog if Chinese people cook it. You know Chinese people like leaving the head on everything? In the most gruesome death, like... if Chinese people made it, no.
The hanging ducks and
stuff. It's even funnier because we've all seen that
before. They always gotta leave the head like...
a fucking duck with a dead...
Like, I got fucking boiled alive, motherfucker. Always gotta leave it like
so
that.
True, dude.
They somehow find a way to deep fry a chicken where their face is morbidly dead. Like,
it's like they're coming at them with a knife real slow and they're like, oh, that's it. Like,
yeah, it's like, fuck.
It's not the face I want. Give it to Moses. Okay, it's got it. Look at that right there.